all the signature lines are more or less connected from year to year, from an older model to a new one. This means that most of the new LeBrons, KDs or Kyries fail to impress in terms of style. Or let me rephrase, they lack the big impact that a completely new silhouette brings to the table. With all that being said, we believe that 2019 has already brought some new and exciting stuff. And boy, we need some new stuff, because quite honestly, most of the designs are beginning to look a lot like something we've seen before. This is Steph from 99 Sneakers, and let's start with the underdog today, Puma. Thanks to some really cool design with the Thunder Spectra, Puma found themselves back in the sneakerhead conversation and even went as far as to bring back their basketball line with the Puma Clyde Court. The brand has been able to sign themselves some pretty talented rookies, including DeAndre Ayton and Kevin Knox, as well as stars like DeMarcus Cousins. Oh, Boogie. The other day, he dunked over a poor guy, and suddenly I realized that he was not on the Clyde courts. Yes, he had just debuted a new Puma basketball shoe called the Uproar, and now Puma is officially unveiling the shoe in the Charlotte Hornets colorway, just in time for All-Star Weekend 2019. These kicks have a ton of color, with an upper that consists of Charlotte blue, purple and orange. The midsole is gradient, as it's white in the front and become orange in the back. Its shoe is different, as the right sneaker has hits of purple on the back, while the left shoe has hits of orange in the same places. The orange pays homage to Charlotte's former name, the Bobcats. Still no price associated with them, but I expect them to be in the mid-low part of the spectrum. Oklahoma City Thunder guard Russell Westbrook is as well known for his swaggy off-court wardrobe as he is for his high-energy game. Last year he debuted his first ever signature basketball sneaker, the futuristic but uncomfortable Jordan Y-Not-01. And to kick things off in the new year, Westbrook is back with the Y-Not-02, a shoe that is somehow even bolder and more daring than the first. You see, at the start of this season, for the first time in league history, the NBA lifted some long-standing restrictions on players' footwear. The change made it so that players no longer had to wear the required white, black or team-colored shoes, and Westbrook and Jordan brand have clearly taken full advantage of the change. The multicolored silhouette of the Y-Not-02 features shades of blue, red, yellow and orange that all sit atop a chunky white sole. And it's not just a glossy, color-packed sneaker either. It features all the same technology as one would expect for the signature shoe of a star player, including a split-sole design. Between the eye-catching design and performance materials, the Y-Not-02 has got just about everything covered. But most noticeably, Westbrook's fashion savvy is showing here. He's managed to apply an over-the-top look that currently dominates the sneaker world, colorful and angly and chunky in just the right ways to a basketball sneaker fit for the highest level of play. Probably the most exciting new shoe of the year. Giannis Antetokounmpo's Nike Greek Freak 1 signature shoe has been rumored for quite some time now, but I believe that finally we're getting there. The leaks are here. Giannis is a captain at the All-Star game as well, and his team, the Milwaukee Bucks, are the hottest team in the NBA right now. This summer is going to be Giannis summer, sneaker-wise. With a very low rumored price, the new Greek Freak ones will be scooped up by the younger hoops devotees. Whatever Giannis is going to bring to the table, it's going to be exciting. Because firstly, Giannis is exciting, and secondly, it's going to be the first of its line, and for that reason, the bar of hype is set pretty high. And since Giannis is my fellow countryman, I'm definitely pumped up to see this debut really soon. Aren't you? So what's the most exciting issue in your opinion? Is it the new Puma, the new Russ shoe, or the Greek Freak one? Which one you got? Waiting for your comments below. Have a great day and remember, liking the video and subscribing to our channel would mean the world.